Everybody, Papa Dennis here, another Keyboard Chronicles video. Thanks for tuning in. This video, something different for me. I tackled the tune Sirius, that's S-I-R-I-U-S, by the Alan Parsons Project. And I did this because one of my viewers, Thomas, asked me about some of the sounds in Sirius. How do you get some of those sounds on the MODX? So I listened to it, and there's a lot going on, and it turns out that you really can't do everything on the MODX. You can get most of the sounds that you hear, but it's just not possible to have them all going at the same time. So I created a backing track using Logic Pro 10, and this video is going to be in two parts. Part one, I'm going to talk about getting the sounds in Sirius on the MODX. Part two, we're going to jump into the computer inside Logic Pro 10, and I'll show you how I built the backing track that I just played along with. Okay, so the first thing that happens in this song is a drone, which is a pretty easy sound to find on the keyboard. And there's quite a few low synth sounds that'll approximate what you hear. The one I chose is called, it's right here, Polypad MWDA. And it's just kind of a sawtooth, low synth bass sound. That's how the tune starts. The next part that comes in is this. For that sound, I chose a hollow clav right here, part one. And one of the key things about it is you need a delay to give you that repeating. Hear how the notes are repeating? Yeah, so I chose a tempo cross delay, right? Insert B, tempo cross delay. And then I needed to find a 1/16th echo, because it's kind of like the repeats are da 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 da. Those are 16th notes. That's not one of the presets. But if you go to Insert B tab here, and you go to delay time, now you have other options for the repeats. They call it delay time, essentially how quickly it repeats. So I selected 1/16th, and I also made the wetness higher in comparison to dry, meaning you lower the dry and you get more. So that's the second thing that happens in the song. Now, scene two is when this next line comes in. This one, I don't know how close it is to the original, but I used it, and let's see what it is. It's three parts playing together, three parts layered. The first one's just a harp sound, FM harp. Let me solo it. That's FM harp. It's the name of that performance. I layered that with a synth called Uni Punch. That just adds a little attack to it. And then I also threw in a little of this thing called Big Bass. Next, what happens next? Oh, yeah. So that's basically the first part of the tune. Oh, the guitar solo that you heard, that was played in Logic Pro 10 using a synth guitar. And when we jump over to Logic Pro 10 inside my computer, I'll show you that. And I just played basically the same guitar solo that I heard on the original recording. Next, scene three is where the yeah, that one, I never did find really the right sound for that, but I guess in the context of the mix, I got away with it. I didn't spend a lot of time trying to duplicate that exact. I threw in an organ layered with that hollow clav sound again. So that, yeah, that I admit is not really exactly like the record, but that part of the song where it goes into kind of a dreamy, atmospheric kind of a vibe, and then there's some improvisational things going on. So that's basically it for what I did in the MODX. Let's jump over to Logic Pro 10 and look how I, and I'll show you how I built the backing track for this.
Here we are inside Logic Pro 10, and this song took a lot of tracks. There's quite a few different things going on, or well, not that many things going on, but the main problem I had with it was getting that big sound. And of course, the Alan Parsons Project original has just a huge sound to it, and that's not so easy to accomplish. So, but this is my attempt, which you've already heard. So let's break it down. First of all, let me show you all the tracks. Here we go. Let's open this baby up. Yeah, it just fit on my screen. Just fit. Okay. So, yeah, a lot of tracks, and you'll see when I start to play, you're going to see faders moving, and I'll show you how that's done. The automating of some of the parameters of individual tracks, I'll show you how that's done. So, all right, let's stop it, and let's break it down. So, it starts with that drone. And that drone is done with these three tracks. Okay. And basically this guy is this sound. And that's panned hard left. This one's the same sound panned hard right. And then this is a more gritty synth bass sound. And those three combined, let's start it again. Give you that drone. Let's talk about how you can automate things like volume and many other parameters on any given track. In Logic Pro, you press A to view automation. And so if we look at this track that's highlighted, you'll see I've got the volume envelope in yellow. And as it starts, you'll see, let me just solo this track. It's getting louder and louder. Then I've got the volumes go up and down a little bit just to add some interest to it. Okay, let's stop it right there. I'll press A again to close the automation view. Now the next thing that comes in after that droning bass is this that sound. Now, to approximate what I heard on the original, I ended up selecting, believe it or not, a clavinet sound. And that's what it sounds like. And it's somewhat close to the record. Maybe not perfect, but it's sort of close. And one of the key things about that line, that repeating line, is the echo. So here's the echo insert on that track, and you'll see that I've got it set to a 1/16th note echo, fairly wet. That's the 44% wetness here, with some feedback. And if you listen to it, if I turn the echo off, back to here. So this is without echo. And that's essential because the original has that repeating sound. And I'm guessing that they did it with echo, but I can't be 100% sure. There's other ways to do that, but echo works. Now, at this point, we have some of the more dramatic stuff coming in. And what's happening? First of all, The drum started here, and that's just a kick drum. Right? It's this track. With a cymbal in there. And then when we get to this measure here, measure 12, then other stuff happens. In fact, let me loop this guy, just this measure. And here's a big, it's called Action Strikes. This is a plugin from Native Instruments. It's like basically cinematic, big cinematic drum hits, like that one, for example. That's like a big tom-tom. Okay, so there's that. And at the same time, this guy, synth guitar, and the sound is, okay, it's a synthesized guitar. Alright, that's that happening. And we have this guy happening. That's just a low synth sound. And this guy is from the Native Instruments Massive synthesizer. You can see it over on the left here. Massive. Another Massive synth is this one. Okay, that's more of a sawtooth with some movement to it. And then the Native Instruments Grandeur piano. Okay, it's just hitting a low B note. And that's it for this part of the song. So the kick drum starts back here. Let's go back. Now let me stop there for a minute and talk about the chords. Basically, there are no chords being played in the song, but the lines that happen here, and then we're going to get to other lines a little later in the song, those repeating lines kind of give you a clue as to what the chords are. And basically all it is a B minor to a G to an E minor back to a B minor. That recurs throughout the first half of the song. And then the second half of the song transitions into a whole new feeling and changes up to the key of D minor. So it goes from B minor to D minor. So let's continue going back here. There's the G. And that's an E. Back to the B minor. And the E was basically an E minor, I believe. Okay. Something new is happening here. These three tracks are playing that second line that comes in, and okay, that's what that sounds like. And in addition to that, I use two ordinary harp sounds, or basic harp. This is a synthesized harp kind of a sound. Again, it's in the Massive plugin from Native Instruments. Then I have two harp tracks, which are just conventional harp sounds, right? Okay, your basic harp sound. Plenty of reverb. Do I have any echo in this guy? No, just some reverb. Now, for more drama, some strings come in, starting here, measure 24, and the strings are a violin ensemble. These two tracks are violin ensemble. This track is violin ensemble, panned hard right, violin ensemble, panned hard left, viola ensemble, hard right, and viola ensemble, hard left. You can duplicate tracks and then pan them left and right to make a sound bigger, basically. Now, what happened there? Up the top here, At this point in the song, the drummer track kicked in. And these drum patterns are part of the drummer feature that's built into Logic Pro 10, that comes with Logic Pro 10. It's a very powerful drummer. It's actually multiple drummers. In fact, let me show you quickly. Yeah, when you use the drummer feature in Logic Pro 10, and to do it, when you add a track, you can select drummer. So it's not categorized as a software instrument or audio, but it's a separate drummer type. I guess you would call it a plug-in. Not sure what you call it exactly. Or they just call it the drummer, and it's really pretty awesome. First of all, you have a choice of multiple styles of music. Look over on the left here: rock, alternative, songwriter, R&B, etc. And under each one of these, you have multiple drummers that you can select. And like for this song, I selected the rock genre and the hard rock drummer Anders. Okay, and I also selected the a drum kit called the SoCal, which I think stands for Southern California. And it's just a nice sounding drum kit. I use it a lot. I happen to like it. It's just an I found it to be a very useful good all around drum kit. So here let's go back. Drums are going to kick in. We get to measure 27 here. Okay, let's stop again. Here comes the guitar solo. And I pretty much copied what I heard on the record, more or less. And I used a synth guitar. Again, it's from the Native Instruments Massive synthesizer. You see it over here. And it's got a lot of inserts, effects inserts, a noise gate, a pedal board. And if you look at the pedal board, it's got an overdrive unit and a delay unit. We've also got some tremolo, another amp, okay, guitar rival amplifier, some EQ, some compression. So it's a pretty heavily affected guitar. And let me just show you the automation for this guy. Over here, I just opened up the automation view, and when you do automation, you can select any of the adjustable parameters that might be available for whatever instrument the track uses, or whatever effects, as well as effects. Okay, in this case, I created an envelope to adjust the tremolo as the track plays. And that's the green envelope you see here. So you can hear when this amplitude gets high on the tremolo depth, you hear the tremolo, and then as it fades, the tremolo fades. And I guess I listened to the guitar solo in the original tune, and there's kind of a tremolo effect happening there also. So again, I try to add realism. It's really hard to mimic a good guitar lead with any synthesizer or even the MODX keyboard. It's just hard to do. But this was my attempt at it, and it's in the context of a mix, it sounds okay. So let's listen to it. Forgot to mention something else that started here when the drummer comes in, back at measure 28 here. This repeating bass line starts. it's these two tracks right here. And basically it's just, up here it is. The bass is just going B and then G. Right, that's here. And then to the E. Right. The E, right. And back to the B. And I've got the same line happening. One track is panned hard left, the other track panned hard right. So that starts when the... Now, after the guitar solo, now we're transitioning into the second half of the song, which has a totally different feel than the first half. It's more dreamy, it's less dramatic. And let's listen to that a little bit. So what's happening there is those drones, and again, it's these three guys, they're just playing a D. And that's a D. Okay, so we've transitioned now from B minor to D minor. And this goes on for a while. Okay. And you'll see the drums, the kick drum's gonna come back in. Oh, before that though, these other lines come in down here. Let me just solo these three tracks. Okay, I tried to approximate what I was hearing on the record. I don't know how close it is, but it's reasonably close. It's something like the record. So let's... Okay. Now the kick drum comes back. And then we're going to start hearing some hits. That's a D. B flat, G, back to D. And that's pretty much it for this Logic Pro project. When you get into the second half of the song, there's some other stuff going on, and I opted to just do those little... They're kind of like improvised solos. And I opted to do those live on the MODX keyboard, as you saw when I played this at the beginning of this video. So that's pretty much it. And then this just goes on, and it eventually fades out, and it's over. So it's pretty dramatic, quite a production. And it took me a while to do all of this, but I enjoyed doing it. And I hope you found this instructive. So thanks for watching.